Hello everybody. In this question, we have to write down the properties of electromagnetic waves. So let's just start with the question and start writing all the properties. The first property which we should keep in mind is that the electromagnetic waves are produced by accelerated charge. Whenever a charge is accelerated, it produces electromagnetic waves. So the first point should be written as it is produced by accelerated charge. Now moving on, the second property of electromagnetic waves is that they are non-mechanical waves. This means that electromagnetic waves do not require a medium for their propagation. They can travel in vacuum also. So the electromagnetic waves are non-mechanical in nature. Next point. Electromagnetic waves are transverse in nature. The electromagnetic waves are transverse in nature. It means that the magnetic field vector and electric field vector are perpendicular to each other, and they are also perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation. Now, moving on to the next point. The next point that we should know about electromagnetic waves is that in vacuum, they travel with the speed of light. So their speed is constant, which is equal to C is equal to 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meters per second. Now, if the light ray goes into another medium where the refractive index of the medium is mu, in that medium, the speed of the electromagnetic waves is given by V is equal to C upon mu, where mu is the refractive index of that medium. Next point, electromagnetic waves are not deflected by electric field or magnetic field. They have electromagnetic waves do not have any charge on them, so they are not deflected by electric field or magnetic field. So basically, electric field or magnetic field do not have any effect on electromagnetic waves. And the last point that we should keep in mind is that electromagnetic waves carry energy and momentum with them. So writing that electromagnetic waves can carry energy and momentum. So I hope this question is clear to all of you. Hello everybody. In this question, we have to explain the types of emission spectrum. There are basically three types of emission spectrum. So let's start discussing them. The first type of emission spectrum is called continuous. Hello, everybody. In this question, we have to explain the types of emission spectrum. There are basically three types of emission spectrum. So let's start discussing them. The first type of emission spectrum is called continuous spectrum. Continuous spectrum. Now, what is a continuous spectrum? We know that whenever a body burns, it produces light. This light has all the possible wavelengths. Now, when this light is passed through a prism, the light gets dispersed. Now, in this above picture, the first picture, which is showing continuous spectrum, in this picture shown, the light emitted by a bulb is producing some light, and the light produced by the bulb is passing through a prism, and then on passing through the prism, it gets dispersed, and its spectrum, the spectrum is shown to you. If you will notice the spectrum, you will see that the spectrum is continuously distributed. There are no separate boundaries for each color. The complete spectrum is continuously distributed. So the first thing that we should keep in mind about continuous spectrum is that it is continuous in nature. There are no separate boundaries. Okay, so this continuous spectrum is distributed on a dark background. So basically, this spectrum is called a continuous spectrum. There is nothing special about this. Now, the second thing, moving along, the second type of emission spectrum is called a line spectrum. Line spectrum. Now, what is a line spectrum? We know that all substances are made up of atoms. When energy is given to the atoms, they get excited to a higher energy level. Now we also know that when an atom comes to a lower energy state from a higher energy state, then it releases a light of certain fixed wavelength. The wavelength of light emitted is always fixed. Okay, so this is the main reason for line spectrum. So look at the diagram for the line spectrum, and I'll make you understand what is this. The light from the hot gas, we have heated a gas so that its atom, the atoms of this gas are promoted to a higher energy level. So the light from the hot gas is passed through this prism. So the first thing that we should keep in mind about light spectrum, that this is a hot gas, so that its atoms are on a higher energy state. Now, when the light from this gas is passed through the prism and its spectrum is obtained, we see that this spectrum has certain sharp lines on a dark background. The background is dark, but there are certain sharp lines. I'm showing this to you. These are all the lines on a dark background. Okay, so let me just write it down. We see that there are sharp lines on a dark background. This spectrum, where there are some sharp lines over a dark background, this spectrum is called an emission spectrum. Moving along, the third type of emission spectrum is called the band spectrum. Third type of emission spectrum is called the band spectrum. Now, what is a band spectrum? It is a very simple thing. If instead of gas atoms, there were gas atoms, instead of these gas atoms, if molecules are excited, basically the reason for the formation of band spectrum is the excited molecules. So instead of atoms, gas atoms, if molecules are excited, then the wavelength emitted on de-excitation, wavelength emitted on de-excitation form separate groups. Okay, so the things that we should write about band spectrum is that it is formed due to excited molecules. It is formed due to excited molecules. And on de-excitation, the wavelength forms separate groups. They are not discrete like in line spectrum. In this, they form separate groups or bunch, if you want to say. The wavelength forms separate groups or bands. Okay, so these bands are separated from each other. For an example, I'm showing you a kind of band spectrum. For example, in a band spectrum, there are certain wavelengths which will bunch together themselves. Okay, so a band spectrum, a typical band spectrum will look like this. It is a band of blue color for blue wavelength. Now, separated from this will be spectrum from green color. Separated from this will be a spectrum of, let's suppose, yellow color. Each of this group is called a band. Each of this group is called a band. So basically, these are the three types of emission spectrum. I hope this question is clear to all of you. In this question, we have to explain the types of absorption spectrum. There are basically two types of absorption spectrum. The first one is known as the line absorption spectrum. Line absorption spectrum. Now, what is the line absorption spectrum? To make you understand, I have a diagram. So let's take a look on this. As shown in the diagram, when white light passes through a sample of gas, the bulb is producing the light, and that white light is passing through a sample of gas, the gas atoms will absorb some light, and it will take them from a lower energy level to a higher energy level. Now, when the emergent light passes through the prism, we get the spectrum. Now, this gas sample has absorbed some energy. This gas sample has absorbed some energy. So these are the points that we should keep in mind. The first thing that we should write is that the atoms will absorb some light. Now, when this prism will form the spectrum, there will be some dark lines. there will be some wavelength that will be missing because the gas sample has absorbed some light. So the second thing that we should keep in mind is on the spectrum, there are some missing wavelengths. Not all wavelengths are present. Some wavelengths are missing. There are some missing wavelengths. Okay, so some wavelengths are missing from the spectrum and we get few dark lines on a bright background. Let me just show you. Look at these. These are some of the dark lines. These corresponding to the wavelength which are absorbed by the sample of the gas. So in line absorption spectrum, we get a few dark lines. These dark lines are called the line absorption spectrum. Now the second type of absorption spectrum is known as the band absorption spectrum. Band absorption spectrum. Now, what is a band absorption spectrum? If instead of atoms, light is absorbed by the gas molecules, there are no atoms over here, there are only molecules, then the missing wavelengths are grouped together into bunches. The missing wavelengths, they form a little groups. So instead of these dark lines, we get dark bands on a bright background. These dark bands are called band absorption spectrum. So the thing that we should keep in mind that in this case, there are molecules which absorb the light. Molecules. And instead of dark lines, we get dark bands. We get dark bands on a bright background. So these are the two types of absorption spectrum. I hope this answer is clear to all of you.